So guys, welcome to the channel. Don't forget to like, subscribe and comment. So today we are going to talk about complete A to Z procedures, problems, questions asked about the STCW online modular courses and some competency exams. So this is your circular number 13 of 2020 on 1st April 2020 that about the STCW modular courses to the e-learning processes. And DG has given 23 STCW modular courses in their e-learning platform. And it is, as per new regime, it is mandatory to complete the e-learning modules. And like, even if you, so there are some courses which are approved for online courses and you'll get the certificates. But the other courses which are not approved, that also you have to do through the e-learning modules. And if you, then after that, you have to go to the MTI, Maritime Training Institutes. And if you don't complete the e-learning module, your certificates will not be generated by MTI. Once you enroll for the course, you have 180 days to complete your course from the date of enrollment. And go to the MTI, do the course, and then the third is you have to pass the exit exam for the course. If you fail for the exam, you can enroll again and with the fees, and you can give the exam again. Three attempts are allowed, and within the three attempts, you can clear the exam. Otherwise, you have to start all the course again. So what are the requirements for these courses? You should have a desktop of laptop with Windows 7 and 2-megapixel camera. Even your mobile you can use for the course, but for the exit exam, you need desktop or laptop is better. Google Chrome is written here, but it does not work actually good on Google Chrome. You need Firefox is the best as of now. Even Internet Explorer you can use. Good lighting for face recognition has to be there. That is a very important point. Whenever you are doing face, a lot of people are facing problems regarding your face photo update. So very good lighting is the best thing for facial recognition, and a good internet speed, not very good, but it's little bit okay. So how you do the access of e-learning procedure is given in this circular, and we will see practically. Go to the DG Shipping e-learning and go to and for STCW modular courses, and you enroll, and then you check your mobile number, email, and click submit. You will get an email and welcome name and password in your email, and with that link you can open the modular course. Now the steps to access the e-learning modular courses is you go to this DG Shipping again, and you start the modular course, and from the modular welcome letter you put this thing, and they will ask you to capture the photo, allow the permission, and they will verify the photo from the photo on the database of your DG Shipping. And once it is done, then you can see the access the course. So you can click on the topics and subtopics to access the related content and go through topic wise content to complete the course. The time required will be given in this e-learning module, and at the end of this circular also, we can see how much time is required for each course that you have to complete. Otherwise, you cannot appear for the exam. And course-wise passing percentage also you see mostly 50%, but some courses are 60 and advanced courses have 70%. Also, you have more frequently asked questions regarding the problems in the technical support on this DG link in the e-learning. Then also you have an opportunity, if you still don't understand something, there is a very good material in this DG e-learning itself with videos and very nice explanations and quizzes. So guys, don't worry, it's very easy to pass these exams. And still, if you have any doubt, you have a facility for live question and answer session. You can register like with this link, which if you read in detail, you can see later on. Just go to this and it's very easy. You will see practically. Then you have the list with modular courses, course IDs, the duration, and recommended hours, minimum study hours, and passing percentage. So for a basic chemical tanker oil, you have 39 hours course with 28 is minimum and passing percentage is 50. For ASCO, at least 32 hours, 70% passing. Chemco, Gasco, Chemco, 70% passing, 28 hours. GTF, like LGTF, 20 hours, 50% passing. Gasco, 31 hours, 70% passing. You can see advanced courses, Chemco, Tesco, Gasco, 70%. Others are 50-60%. And other courses, you can see there are 23 courses. All the courses of DG Shipping are given here. You can see PSSR, PSCRB, Refresher, PSCRB, 12-60%, AFF, RAFF, and all this. Now, next, we also had an update of this DG Circular 20 of 20. We were waiting for a long time. On 20th July, we got this regarding the conduct of courses and issuance of certificate of proficiency, that is your modular courses certificate. So, it is as per CCW, whoever is having COC and or COPs for ABs, they are required to do this modular courses, and every 5 years, they are required to do the refresher courses from some courses regarding the from the maritime training institutes. And till COVID-19 normalcy is restored, it will take at least 1-2 years, 3 years, and this process we have to keep doing till now, till that time. So it's a three-tier approach. First you have to do from the e-learning, then virtual classes from the institute, and then you have to pass the exit examination on the DG portal, and the certificate will be generated on the DG site. So this COC, this is applicable for those people who COC or COP or modular courses certificate or COC, if it is expiring before 31st December 2021, then we have to do these courses also for revalidation. And you should have at least 1 year of sea service in last 5 years for COC revalidation. So these are the 12 courses which are approved for online classes, mostly refresher courses of PST, PSCRB, FPFF, and advanced firefighting, medical first aid, then some revalidation courses for engineers. Then basic and advanced tanker courses, OCTO, LGTF, ASCO, Chemco, Gasco, and Liquid Handling Simulator. And other courses, then these certificates will be digitally signed by the institute principal and the course in charge and the candidate. Signature will be automatically uploaded from the DG Shipping database. So you make sure your photo and digital signature is uploaded on the DG site. And if regarding the online exit exam, if you still have some query, you can refer to the circular 17 of 2020. And there are some other circulars regarding the, circulars have 18 months of validity for those certificates which are having validity. Like Tesco, Chemco, they don't have any validity. So still there will be no validity. The others which are having 5 years validity, these courses will have only 18 months validity. So you can see in this circular 16 of 2020 or this other S standard operating procedures for these courses. So you can see a period of 18 months validity from the date of passing the exit exam for PST, PSCRB, FPFF, AFA, MFA, and their refresher courses also. So the main courses of PST, PSCRB, Advanced Firefighting, MFA, whichever are having practical classes, required practicals, they are Medicare. They are like Medicare, they need a hospital visit. So these courses are not approved as of now as we have seen the list. Only some refresher courses and tanker courses are approved, which are required by the STCW. So to start with, you type DG Shipping in your listing and it would ask that it is risky, and you can just go to advanced. It's best to do in Mozilla Firefox, that's why we are doing, and accept the risk and continue. And e-governance will be open. You go to e-learning, you click modular courses, and and whichever modular course you want to do, you first you can put your username and password, and it will ask you to allow for webcam. You can allow for webcam and sign in. And here the face verification is failed, but you can allow again. And if you refresh the page, sometimes it will allow and ask you. So guys, this is about the DGS circulars. What all procedure was there for modular courses? Don't forget to like, subscribe, share or comment. And in our next video, we will see the practical way of attending the modular courses and what are the problems faced and how to solve them.